In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Dear audience, this is Language and Linguistics Online. I am Dr. Khurram Shahzad from National University of Modern Languages, Islamabad. Today, I intend to talk about psycholinguistics. It is one of the important disciplines of linguistics. Let me introduce, first of all, the definition of psychology, linguistics, and then psycholinguistics. In today's video, I shall talk about scope of psycholinguistics and limitations of psycholinguistics. The scientific study of mind and behavior is called psychology, and the scientific study of language is called linguistics. So, psycholinguistics and neurolinguistics explore how the human brain and mind acquire, process, understand, and produce language. So, in psycholinguistics, we will be talking about how language is acquired by human beings and what kind of processes they go on in the mind of the person, and then how they produce language. It is very important to understand why students, when they are learning the language, or particularly the children, they may make use of the word "good" instead of "went." And it shows how mind makes use of grammar, because grammar talks about grammatical rules. So once the students, they acquire different kind of rules, they generalize these rules, and they think instead of saying "went," they make use of "good." In the same way, when we talk about Urdu, we come across children, they are making use of sentences and they are unable to understand the difference of gender. So a girl who is learning Urdu language says "gaya tha," because she is hearing this language from the male members of the society. So she is unable to distinguish that instead of saying "gayi thi," she says "gaya tha." So again, we can understand that the kind of rules these children, they are acquiring, they sometimes overgeneralize these rules, and in this way they make wrong sentences, they create wrong sentences. One of the definitions of psycholinguistics is, it is the study of mental processes involved in the comprehension, production, and acquisition of language. It sits at the intersection of psychology, cognitive science, and linguistics. I will be following different books. One of the books that I will be following is Psychology of Language. Other book that I will be following is Fundamentals of Psycholinguistics. Incident is explained in the Psychology of Language, and I should read this small paragraph. A man walks into a bar after a long trip. He phones his partner and says, "I am here now." His partner thinks he is in New York and on a business trip. But in fact, he has gone to London to play poker with his friend. Yet what he says was strictly true. So we need to understand the kind of steps which are involved when the human beings, they produce this language. First of all, we should have a biological hardware. Because of that biological hardware, we are able to produce language. We are able to understand language. And of course, then we have got structural apparatus. For example, we have got pharynx, we have got lips, we have got tongue, we have got vocal cords. And in this way, we are producing language. So first of all, we need the hardware. Then we require the structural apparatus so that we should produce the language. Then we need to understand the kind of relationship we human beings are enjoying with our listener. So lexicon that we have got in the mind, the mental lexicon, the mental dictionary, which is a repertoire of knowledge. From that repertoire of knowledge, we have made certain selections. We have made choice of the language, what to say, how to say, and what not to say, and what not to, and how not to say it. So keeping in mind the listener, we produce the language, we make choices from the mental repertoire that we have got. So in this way, we need to understand the social aspects of language as well. Because if we do not understand the context, if we do not understand the society, we cannot produce the language which is desired at that particular time. We also need a language complex enough to convey the kind of message that we need to convey. As young children, we need to acquire that language. Finally, we have to be aware of the social setting to produce and behave in a certain way. So in this series of lectures, I will be talking about different kinds of processes, psychological and mental processes, which are involved in the comprehension, understanding, and production of the language. Psychology of language talks about David Crystal. David Crystal has talked about 8 different uses of language or functions of language. The very first function is communication. Secondly, we make use of language to talk about our emotions, for example, by swearing. Thirdly, we make use of this language for social interaction. For example, if somebody sneezes and we say, bless, may God bless you. We also create different kinds of sounds when children, they are playing different kinds of games. We also make use of language and try to control the environment. We also make use of language and we construct reality. We construct truth and lies. And in this way, we expose our identity. Most importantly, we also make use of language to create humor. And in this way, we make use of puns in the language. So what we are doing, we are trying to understand the psychology of language. How human beings, the kind of behavior they are displaying, the kind of behavior they are exposing through their language will be the subject of this series of lectures. So in psycholinguistics, we examine the psychology of language. We try to understand that how language is produced, how we understand when someone else is producing the language. So what are the processes which are involved in the production, understanding, and comprehension of language. Now I should talk about the scope of psycholinguistics. So very first thing is language acquisition. How children and adults, they learn language. Number 2 is language comprehension. How listeners and readers, they understand spoken and written language. Number 3 is language production. How we plan and speak or write the language that we are making use of. We also talk about lexical access, how words are stored and retrieved from our memory. So later on, I shall talk about short-term memory and long-term memory and their role. We also talk about speech perception, how we understand sounds and distinguish between them. We also talk about bilingualism or multilingualism, how multiple languages are processed and stored. We also talk about language disorders, for example, aphasia or dyslexia. So scope of language, we can talk about these days, the kind of researches students are doing in the Department of Linguistics and the kind of research articles which are being produced these days and different kinds of journals that are being available to the people these days. So all these things will come under the scope of psycholinguistics. For example, in language acquisition, we will talk about how children, they acquire the grammar of the language. Because it is sometimes without explicit explanation. So we acquire the language, but in our schools and colleges, we teach the language. And we understand the language, which can be a different language other than the mother tongue. In English, a child says, I go there. It shows the application of a rule. For example, ed is added with the first form of the verb. Before learning irregular forms of verbs, children sometimes they produce such type of sentences. In Urdu, a child says, tu gaya tha, instead of tu gayi thi, because the child is unable to distinguish between the gender, because Urdu is a gendered language. We also talk about speech errors. And in this way, we try to understand how language is produced. For example, instead of saying you have missed all of my mystery lectures, people may say you have hissed. So how the ma sound, it is not being produced, or why the ma sound is not being produced? What are the reasons? So sometimes we make slips of the tongue when we are speaking the language. Now, lastly, we need to understand the limitations of psycholinguistics. Abstract mental processes are difficult to measure directly. So still, because it is a new subject, there are limitations to this subject. Most research is based on English and European languages, and usually in psycholinguistics, in Urdu or Hindi, Pashto or Punjabi, research is not being carried out. Cultural factors are often ignored. So this is also one of the limitations of psycholinguistics. For example, the use of honorifics in Urdu. The connection between language and emotion is also underexplored. So these are some of the limitations of psycholinguistics. Dear audience, in this short video, I have introduced the subject of psycholinguistics. I have discussed some definitions of psycholinguistics. I have talked about scope and limitations of psycholinguistics. Thank you very much.